In September 2015, it looked as though SMUD had stepped back in time to the Old West. In reality, we employed a mix of old school and modern technology for a one-of-a-kind project in the Desolation Wilderness. Our mission was to install a large valve on the Rubicon Dam, but paved roads end 7 miles short of the dam, and mechanized travel is not allowed in the wilderness, except by special permission.
The suggestion for using mules started with Forest Service, and it was a little shocking for us, not knowing how to handle that.
How do you transport men, equipment, supplies, and materials using primitive means and still accomplish the goal in a reasonable amount of time?
SMUD employees camped at the dam for 10 days, and we kept that mule train rolling to resupply them. A pack outfit from the Bishop area supplied the mules and handlers.
Yesterday we had 15 pack animals, and we made two trips, so basically that gave us 30 loads into the Rubicon Dam. So we'll do the same today. We'll make two trips and get another 30 loads in there, and maybe even a few more.
The Forest Service gave us permission for a limited number of helicopter trips to haul equipment that was too heavy for the mules, including the valve that weighed 2,300 pounds and sections of pipe that weighed almost as much. Each load was carefully planned, organized, and weighed ahead of time.
The hardest part of this project was definitely the logistics coming up to the project.
Case oversaw the planning and was the boss at the dam. A mechanical engineer, she also designed critical parts, making sure they didn't exceed the helicopter's weight limit.
All of the components are custom fabricated from thin-walled aluminum for the weight considerations and getting it to the site. None of this stuff is found off the shelf anywhere.
A dozen SMUD employees from Fresh Pond worked 12-hour days and had a designated cook to keep them going. Others from Fresh Pond played important support roles.
By far the most intense day was the day the large equipment came in on that Friday, and everybody did exactly what they're supposed to. Nobody freaked out, which happens often when working under helicopters, and could not be happier with how that went.
When we finally got organized on this project and it was clear we were going to use both helicopters and mules, it was rather frightening. We'd never done this before. And the safety implications are huge. We spent many hours, many days talking about how this whole project could come together safely. And in the end, we were successful. We completed this project with no safety incidents. The credit goes to the team that worked on this and brought this project together safely.
Well, you guys have a good day.